And there is a pending motion by Congressman Ron Salo to cite Attorney Harry Roque in contempt for lying before this committee when he submitted an excuse to his being absent in our hearing last August 16. Now, pursuant to our rules, Section 11 of the Rules of Procedure Governing Inquiries in Aid of Legislation, it says that the committee may punish any person for contempt by a vote of 2/3 of the members present, there being a quorum. The following shall be the grounds for citing any person in contempt. In this case, as stated by Congressman Salo, the reason for the contemptible act committed by our resource person is in paragraph E, which reads, acting in a disrespectful manner towards any member of the committee or any misbehavior in the presence of the committee. So, may I solicit comments from our members before we rule on this motion? In the spirit of fairness, because the committee has been citing our resource persons who have violated this rule in contempt and detaining them before detaining them in the premises of the House of Representatives. Would there be any comment from our members?
Mr. Chair, before we vote,
Chairman Labonte,
before we vote of the contempt, we would like to hear first the explanation of the reason behind his absence to this committee last year.
Thank you, Your Honor. I was hoping to be given an opportunity to be heard. It was an honest mistake, Your Honor. I have also been a member of this chamber. We don't hold hearings on Fridays. So when I saw the notice of hearing, I assumed that just like the first and the second hearing where I attended, that it would be on a Thursday. And that is true, that I had a hearing both in the morning and in the afternoon. And that is why I sent that letter. By the time I realized that it was a Friday and there was in fact a hearing, it was also close already to lunchtime and the hearing was in Pampanga. So I apologize for the honest mistake, but the truth of the matter is I have been here on Thursdays, so two hearings already, and I just assumed that just like in the past where we don't hold hearings on a Friday, that the hearing would be on a Thursday, as in fact today is also a Thursday. So it was an instance of, okay, there's a hearing, it's on Thursday again, and I have a hearing on Thursday, that's why I sent the letter right away, not even realizing that 16 is a Friday. That was an honest mistake. Had I had any intentions not to appear, I would not have appeared today as well. But in the first two instances, and those were the two instances where I was invited, I in fact appeared. I have no wish to disrespect the very same body of which I was a part of, which I consider at some point in time as my happy place, in fact, the House of Representatives. Thank you, Your Honors.
Any other member who wish to make a comment?
Mr. Chairman, can we have
Congressman
a copy,
Fernandez?
Can we have a copy of that certification that was issued by the Regional Trial Court? Because I haven't seen the copy yet. And that's the reason why medyo kanina I was a bit shocked about it. So,
here. So while Congressman Fernandez is still reading the certification,
Mr. Chair, Mr. Chair, I'd like to ask Secretary Roque, what is the reason for your apology?
Well, it was really an honest mistake, Your
Honor. So you're apologizing not for your absence, but for an honest mistake?
It was an honest mistake, Your Honor, because I've been here every Thursday. And as a former member of this chamber, as a former employee of this chamber, I know that in the regular course of business, we don't really have hearings on Fridays. In fact, even if you call the trunk line of the House of Representatives on a Friday, no one will answer. That has always been the policy, no? So when I saw the notice of hearing, I really thought it was also on a Thursday, like the first two hearings where I attended. That is why I apologize for the honest mistake.
Mr. Chair.
Congressman Akop, and then Congressman Paduano, and then Congressman Fernandez. Congressman Akop, you're recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Attorney Roque, nag-assume po kayo na mali, di po ba?
Nagkamali po.
Kaya nga, yung assumption nyo mali.
Opo, mali nga po yun.
And therefore, pag nag-assume ka ng mali, you should be ready for the consequences. Hindi ba dapat ganun?
Yes po, but there was no intent to disrespect this chamber.
I'm not asking whether you have the intent. Ang tinatanong ko lang po doon is, kung nag-assume po kayo ng mali, hindi po ba dapat tanggapin ninyo yung consequences?
I will, of course, accept the consequences, the decision of this body. But since I was given an opportunity to be heard, I thought that there should be allowance for honest mistakes.
Kasi, pagpasensya mo na ako. Kasi ako, I know that you have been practicing as a lawyer for a long time. Di po ba?
Yes, Your Honor.
And as a practicing lawyer, lahat po ng schedule ninyo nakalagay. For example, for the week, kung ano ang hearing mo for the week, ano yung appointment mo, nakalagay po. Di po ba?
Totoo po yun. Kaya nga po, dun sa certificate, talagang may hearing po ako nung Thursday. And mali nga lang po yung assumption ko na yung sumunod na hearing ay hindi na pala Thursday dahil puro Thursday po tayo.
Ang ibig nyo pong sabihin, wala sa schedule ninyo yung dapat umattend kayo ng hearing sa Friday, nung Friday?
Yun nga po, nailagay ko po siya ng Thursday kasi every Thursday po yung hearing natin.
Then, as it is, kayo po lahat ang may kasalanan. Wala.
Opo, pero wala naman.
Participation ng iba.
Opo, pero wala naman pong intention to disrespect the chamber.
Hindi ko po kine-question yung intention nyo. Ang kine-question ko lang, as a practicing lawyer, ang alam ko, yung mga lawyers, meron silang sinusulatan lahat ng kanilang mga schedule. In your case, kung nakalagay yung schedule na yun, dun sa yung event na yun, sa yung book of schedules, dapat alam ninyo.
Sa totoo nga lang po, dahil akala ko Thursday, nakita ko na morning afternoon ng hearing ko, sumulat na ako kaagad to inform the committee as soon as possible dahil ang buong akala ko po talaga Thursday.
Attorney Roque, marami na pong namatay dahil sa maling akala. Kindly bear that in mind. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman Akop. Congressman Paduano, you're recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Anyway, tama po yung sinabi ni Chairman Akop na that's your fault. And you should face the consequences, di ba? Now, eto lang po. Kaya ako, of course, the intent, hindi pwede natin pag-usapan dito yung intent. Kasi, the question is, ito, well, in fact, you're calling the chairman of this committee. Well, in fact, you text me with regards to your request for your wife to be excused in today's hearing. Now, as you mentioned, nalaman mo na after lunch, nag-hearing sa Pampanga. Di ba? At the very least, man lang, sana you texted me, you call me, or you call the chairman na hindi po ako makarating dyan kasi nagkamali ako. But you never do it. Kaya yung question of intent, sabi ko nga, hindi pwede magiging basis for that possible contempt, no? Na minove ni Congressman Ronzalo. Kaya ako, ang ano ko lang dito is supposedly, at the very least, again, you have texted or called us. If not me, you called Chairman Abante, well, in fact, on that request, you called Chairman Barbers. But you never do it. So, ako, Mr. Chairman, I joined the motion of the first motion of Congressman Salo. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Congressman Paduano.
Mr. Chair.
Congressman Fernandez. Congressman Abante.
Mr. Chair, the fact that Secretary Roque appeared with us today and apologized to the committee at sinabi po ni Congressman Acop kung nagkamali siya, eh sinabi naman po nagkamali siya, I'd like to ask that we hold in abeyance the motion until such time that all of us would jointly join the motion of Congressman Salo. Also, I'd like to open this debate to any member of the committee to say something about this, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Chair. Congressman Abante. Congressman Joel Chua, you're recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, gusto ko lang pong tanongin si Attorney Harry Roque. Nung sabi po ninyo kanina, it was just an honest mistake, tama po ba? Dahil sabi po ninyo, ang akala ninyo is Thursday. So, nung Thursday po ba, nagpadala kayo agad ng notice sa amin? Or at the very least, nag-inform po kayo agad?
Tuesday po, pinadala ko po. Dahil nakita ko conflict nga po sa calendar.
Tuesday
po.
So, na-realize lang ninyo na Friday pala nung
Friday na po at nabalitaan ko na nagko-quad hearing po sa Pampanga.
Pero yung quad hearing, parang umaga pa lang po yata. May quad hearing na eh. Tama po ba?
Correct po. I took the day off because I was also not feeling well last Friday.
So, no Friday po, masamang pakiramdam ninyo?
Yes po. Opo.
So, ano pong ginawa ninyo nung Friday, nung na-realize ninyo? Wala po ba? Dati po, sabi po ninyo kanina, na iba po sa amin, kasabay pa po ninyo. Wala po ba kayong kahit isang man lamang po na tinext o tinawagan?
Well, kasi masama din po talaga ang aking pakiramdam. And in fact, I have a medical certificate today where the doctor recommended that I should be confined in a hospital. Pero I did not consider that because I said I have to appear now because I missed the last hearing. But I have the medical certificate if your honors would wish to see it. But my attendance here reaffirms my commitment to explain and answer all your queries because I have nothing to hide.
Pero nung Friday po ba, hindi po kayo na-confine sa hospital?
Hindi po. Nagpahinga lang po talaga ako because I had very strange feelings for the first time. It was an electric feeling in the neck. And I thought that by just resting, it will go away.